Hello, my name's Russell Dent and I'm an educator at the WSET School in London, and I'm here to talk about challenges in the vineyard in terms of growing grapes. So the first thing we're going to look at are our challenges associated with temperature. So let's start by thinking about what happens if we haven't got enough, if things are a little bit too cold. So our main considerations here, our main challenges would be winter freeze, frost, and cooler temperatures in the spring. So let's start with winter freeze. Winter freeze is when the temperature, typically through the winter, as the name suggests, when the vine's dormant, the temperature is below minus 20 degrees C. So this is sufficiently cold to kill the vine. The most delicate part of the vine is the graft, so that union of the rootstock and the Eurasian species on the top. Preventative measures against winter freeze typically involve protecting that graft in some way, usually by mounding up the earth around the graft to provide some insulation. So our second challenge associated with cooler temperatures is frost. So this is distinct from winter freeze, in that it tends to be a little bit more problematic when the vine is actually active. So this is something that typically happens in spring. So in spring, the temperature's gone up a little bit, the buds start to burst, we've got some green structures on the vine. If at this point the temperature drops below zero, then that can affect the quantity of the buds, it can cause the buds to drop off, and then subsequently that can affect the amount of fruit that the vine is able to produce, and the quality of the fruit that the vine is able to produce. There are lots of different management options for frost. We can use heaters to try and encourage air circulation around the vineyard to mix the warmer, higher air with the colder, lower air. Similarly, we can use fans. So we can mix, again, the cooler, lower air with the higher, warmer air to raise the ambient temperature. We can use sprinkler systems. So these work by spraying the vine with water, and as the water freezes on the vine, it releases a little bit of energy to help protect the vine from excessive cold. And then perhaps more natural approaches, we can look at vineyard selection. So we could look at establishing the vineyard on slopes, and that way the cooler air sinks down the slope, we can protect the vines from those cooler temperatures. Okay, so next we'll talk about cooler temperatures in spring. So this again is distinct from frost, and it's where we have, as the name suggests, slightly cooler conditions in spring than we would like. Temperature is a really important trigger for the growth of the vine. If things are too cool, then the vine will be, I suppose, behind in its growth cycle. Therefore, the time that the vine has to ripen the fruit, sugar, flavors and aromas will be shorter. So if it's cooler in spring, the growing season is going to be shorter. Our ability to get a certain quantity, a certain quality of fruit with a certain flavor profile is more limited. There's not a great deal we can do about cooler temperatures in spring. So we've considered what happens if things are a little too cold. So let's think about what happens if it's too warm. So if the vineyard area is too hot, this can be bad news for the vine. It means that the vine will need a greater quantity of water to help keep itself cool. And if that water isn't available, then the vine will shut down. It will stop the process of photosynthesis, those processes of transpiration, whereby it's releasing water from the leaves to maintain a certain temperature, and hence, in terms of the accumulation of sugars, flavors, and aromas, that will stop. If those very warm conditions are prolonged, then the ability to get the desired quantity of fruit of a certain quality level is reduced. There are several management options for excessive heat. The simplest is to make sure that the vine's got enough water, and that way the vine can attempt to keep itself cool through that process of transpiration. We could also look to establish vines that are closer to the ground, perhaps with some natural shading from the canopy. and that will create a slightly cooler environment for the vine to grow. Okay, so another consideration associated with too much heat in the vineyard, so warmer temperatures, are the risk of fires. So warmer temperatures in the vineyard generally mean drier conditions, and the risk of fire starting is much greater. Fires can obviously destroy vineyards as well as wineries. Actually, there's a much greater risk from smoke produced from fires than actually the fires destroying the vines. And that's because smoke is sticky. It sticks to the grapes and will be detectable as an unpleasant, smoky, sometimes quite a plasticky flavor and aroma in the final wine. In terms of preventing fires, it can be quite difficult, especially where we're at the mercy of slightly warmer, drier conditions. Actually, a lot of the preventative measures are targeting the smoke taint, those unpleasant flavors, and removing those flavors. And winemakers have some techniques that they can use in the winery to try and remove those unpleasant, smoky, and plastic flavors and aromas. Okay, so we can go on to those challenges associated with sunlight, and particularly where we've got too much sunlight or too little sunlight. So let's start with too little. The vine needs sunlight for photosynthesis. Where we've got too little sunlight, the rate of photosynthesis is less, and hence the accumulation of sugars in grapes is much slower. We also associate sunlight with warmth. So where we've got lower levels of sunlight, we've got lower temperatures, and hence the accumulation of flavors, aromas within the grapes is much slower. So this will ultimately result in wines that perhaps taste slightly thin, that are much lighter, perhaps slightly sour, with potentially unpleasant, slightly bitter and astringent flavors and aromas. Conversely, we need to make sure that the vine doesn't get too much sunlight. Too much sunlight means that the rate of photosynthesis is very high. The accumulation of sugar in the grapes is much faster. And we normally associate higher levels of sunlight with more warmth, and hence the accumulation of flavors and aromas is much quicker. Where we've got too much sunlight, this often means the creation of wines that have very high levels of alcohol, unbalanced alcohol, that may have slightly baked or overripe flavors and aromas, and a sense of unbalance in the wine. We can also consider the risk of sunburn on grapes where we've got very high levels of sunlight. So grapes that receive too much sunlight typically discolor, they start to go brown, and we often get flavors slightly burnt or slightly baked flavors as a result. Okay, so finally we're going to consider water availability and the challenges associated with too much and too little water. So as with sunlight and warmth, the vine needs water for that process of photosynthesis. So the creation of sugars in our grapes and ultimately alcohol in our final wine. The vine also needs water to keep itself cool, and water is also important in terms of the vine's ability to take up nutrients from the soil. In terms of challenges associated with water availability, it's really important that the vineyard manager is aware of how much water is available to the vine, because this can affect both the quantity and quality of the fruit. And there's also a risk of where we might have prolonged exposure to too little or too much water, that may affect the health of the vine. So let's start by thinking about what happens if we haven't got enough water. So drought, essentially. In a situation where the vine doesn't have enough water, then photosynthesis will stop. It will also mean that the vine's ability to take up nutrients will be limited. So the accumulation of sugars, flavors, and aromas will slow and eventually stop. If the period of that lack of water is prolonged, then the vine is at risk of death. It needs a certain amount of water to maintain its health and take up those nutrients. In terms of preventative actions that we can take to help manage droughts, one of the most obvious is, well, we can water the vines, we can irrigate. That might be in the form of drip irrigation, sprinklers, flood irrigation, but they are all techniques used to make sure that the vine has sufficient water. If we aren't allowed to irrigate, or if we don't want to irrigate, then there are other options. We can look at varietal selection. Some grape varieties don't need as much water as others. We could think about rootstock selection. Some rootstocks are better suited to drier soils than others. We could think about vineyard design, how close our vines are planted, the concept of vine density. Okay, so let's go on to what happens if we have too much water. So we know that water is an important ingredient in photosynthesis, but the vine can't have too much. We need to think about two areas here, where we've got too much water in the soil and what that means to the health of the roots, and then what the vine's going to do with that water. So if our soil has got lots of water in it, then the vine likes it. And what that means is that the vine will put out lots of green growth. Lots of shoots, lots of leaves, but not a lot of fruit. It's concentrating on green growth and not on berry development. With that additional green growth, we're likely to get more shading in the canopy as well. So the fruit that we may have on the vine is going to get less sunshine. It's likely to be less ripe in terms of the amount of sugars, flavors, and aromas that it contains. In terms of management options for too much water, installing drainage solutions is probably one of the easiest things to do. So we can encourage the water to drain out of the soil more quickly. And that might be to change the soil composition or the installation of drainage pipes. We could also think about, again, rootstock selection, vineyard design, vine density, to manage the amount of water that each vine has access to. Other challenges associated with too much water is untimely rainfall. And this is something that vineyard managers can't really do a great deal about. But where we have a lot of rainfall at flowering, that process of pollination, where we're deciding essentially how much fruit the vine is able to produce. If it's excessively rainy at that point, then that can interrupt successful pollination. So if it's raining at flowering and pollination, then the amount of fruit, the quality of the fruit that we're able to produce could be severely affected. The other point at which untimely rainfall might be a particular problem is at harvest. So if it rains immediately before harvest, the vines will take up that water, causing dilution of the grape components, our sugars, flavors, aromas, acids, and hence the quality of the fruit is likely to be reduced. As I say, it's quite difficult to seek out preventative options, but we might be able to make a decision in terms of when we pick the fruit. We can pick the fruit earlier, or we can run the risk of the water diluting those flavors and aromas. Okay, so finally, in terms of water availability, we can consider hail. So solid rain, essentially. So hail can be incredibly damaging to all parts of the vine. And it's a particular problem where we've got green structures on the vine, which are much more delicate than our woody parts. So hail can strip leaves, it can affect the vine's ability to intercept sunlight and warmth, but it can also split open berries, leaving the vine prone to attack from other pests and diseases. In terms of management options for hail, well, there are two main management options. We can choose to net our vines, to providing some protection, some physical protection, or we could potentially take the fruit from a larger area, and that's because hail tends to be incredibly localized. So we can take a greater proportion of the fruit from those areas that are unaffected by hail. Okay, so let's have a look at a theory question associated with challenges within the vineyard, associated with perhaps water or sunlight or warmth. So our question here is identify and describe two challenges associated with water availability. This is a 6-mark question. You're asked to identify and describe, so we need to say what are those challenges, and then we need to describe those challenges, give a little bit more information about those particular challenges. So our answer here is, could be varied. There are lots of different things we could mention in our response. So we may mention drought, so too little water. And in this instance, too little water means that the vine will essentially shut down. The vine will stop producing sugars. It will stop ripening the fruit. We may have also considered too much water. So too much water available to the vine means lots of green growth, but not a lot of fruit production. And the fruit production, the fruit that is produced, is likely to be more shaded and not as ripe. So in addition to too much or too little, other options in answer to this question might be applicable. Thank you for watching this session. Hope you enjoyed it. Hope you find it useful. Goodbye.